talk about pressure, what it means to deer hunting. So we're talking about low pressure systems and high pressure systems, but really what I want to focus on is high pressure. I've been watching pressure lines for, I would say, a good 5 years, and watching them really hard. Well, probably more like 7 or 8 years. So I wanna go on my phone here and see where we're at right now, so I can get this pulled up. So it's Sunday. Sorry. It's not Sunday. Let me see if I can get this here. Oh, now it's reloading. Okay. 10-day Durand. 10-day. Okay, so what I'm looking at right now is wonderground.com, and you've probably seen this flashed across people's screens. Sometimes when guys mention what the pressure is, or predicting where they're going to hunt, they will call out Wonderground. This app has killed me my last 5 big bucks, okay? It's unbelievable. So right now, it's Thursday, November 26th, it's Thanksgiving. Happy Thanksgiving to all of you. Right now the pressure is 29.96, but if you can see, we just hit a dip. Okay? We were coming off a flat, and now the pressure has bounced. It's bounced back up, and it's on its way up, and it's gonna get to 30.19 tomorrow morning. Tomorrow morning at about 10 a.m. So it's a steady rise from 29 to 30.19 tomorrow morning. And a lot of times when you are coming off of a straight pressure line or a dip in pressure, that first bounce back up is really good. It's really good. Whatever it is with the whitetail, they react to the pressure that's in the air. I mean, it's unbelievable. A lot of times, you know, when I'm deciding when I'm going to go archery hunting, you know, early season archery hunting up until the gun season here in Wisconsin, the gun season is usually, well, it's always starts the Saturday before Thanksgiving. I can see the 10-day pressure forecasts on wonderground.com, and you can too. And I do not go hunting unless it's on a front and the day after is high pressure. It's like clockwork. I shot a 156-inch 10-pointer this year, and the pressure was 30.21. We had got 6 inches of snow the day before, and the pressure had dipped a little bit, and it was bouncing back up, and when I shot that buck, it was 30.21, and it was no accident. 6 inches of snow on the ground, October 21st, rising pressure. It is when the big bucks like to move. It is, there's so many factors on when big bucks move, but the pressure, it's just incredible. A couple of years ago, I had this buck I called Bullwinkle, and every single picture of him, I tracked, and I made this Excel spreadsheet, and I got him in daylight during early October, like so, when early October, I'm saying, before things really started picking up, so like October 1st through October 20th, every time I got him in daylight, the pressure was 30.15 or higher, every single time. And you can look at historical pressure data if you wanted to do this with your pictures of a buck and figure out what they're doing. So you can look at what the pressure was, the wind direction, where they were, what direction they were traveling in. So you can learn just a ton about a deer that you're hunting if you wanted to go into that kind of depth. Now, holy cow, now you got cellular cameras. And if you can see that a buck is showing up in your area on a cellular camera and kind of have him pinned to where it is, if you were on a high pressure system, sunny, bluebird day, pressure over 30.2, I mean, if you get into the range of 30.4, you are dealing with a pressure system that is going to have the big bucks on their feet. I'm telling you, it doesn't matter what time of year it is, there's a good chance that big deer are going to be on their feet when you have a pressure system like that. I like to say, when low temperature and high pressure meet, the bucks are on their feet. You know, so everybody talks about cold fronts, and they absolutely should. But the trick is, you gotta be on that high pressure day following a cold front. And if you have done your homework and have your stand in the right location and you know, have it somewhere in the area where you know that buck is, there's a good chance that you're gonna see that deer. So I killed my buck this year on October 21st and the pressure was 30.2. The next several days in Wisconsin were in the 30s, and there were some days where the pressure dipped, and then Sunday the 25th the pressure was on the rise and it was supposed to be to 30.5 on Monday. We had another really big deer that we were after, and after I shot mine, all I wanted was for my dad to get on this deer. So it was a combination of watching cutting lane cameras, but knowing on Monday the 26th, it was absolutely the perfect time to be in the woods to catch a big deer. And he ended up shooting that buck Monday morning, and the pressure was 30.51. And that deer scored 159 inches. Just an awesome 6.5-year-old deer. A big deer. A deer you should not be catching on their feet, but if you know when to hunt, you can absolutely them on their feet. So we're just flying so high. It's like unreal. I'm my dad shoots this buck, I'm 4 hours away, and I am just like pacing around the house because I want to go celebrate with my dad because this is such an awesome deer. So he shoots that deer at 8:30 in the morning, and I had kind of, you know, come down off the high and kind of settled down and was kind of being able to focus and get back in my routine of what I was doing on that Monday. And I get a text from my Uncle John at 3 p.m. I just shot this one. And I'm like, what? This is incredible. So my uncle shot another 159-inch deer that day. Remember, pressure, 30.51. I'm such a believer, guys. Like, yes, there's days that I'll go in the woods when the conditions aren't as optimal, like what I'm talking about, but it's only in situations like gun season where I'm here and I'm planning to hunt anyway, and you only have 9 days. When you're talking about a bow season, early bow season that goes for 60 days, and then late season after your gun seasons where you've got all these days to pick from, if you can manipulate your schedule, you know, work with your employer or whoever it is, if you can choose when you're going to be in the woods and you watch the fronts but watch the pressure line associated with the fronts, you are going to up your chances of success substantially. And it, you know, I watch all kinds of hunting videos. I'll give a shout out to the Hunting Public Boys. Those guys, their videos are incredible. If you haven't checked them out, you know, I'm a private land hunter who's hunted heavily managed land since I was 12 years old. So it's really easy for me to see good deer, but I have learned so much from those hunting public guys that I've been able to put into practice and has helped me kill a couple of the big bucks I've shot. So I love watching them. I love watching the juries, Mark and Terry Drury and everybody in their company. They're so knowledgeable. You can learn so much from these guys. And then the Midwest Whitetail guys, obviously started by Bill Winky. Well, not obviously, you wouldn't know that if you didn't watch, but Bill Winky, who's just had wild success in his hunting career. But all the guys that he has working Midwest Whitetail right now, my goodness, if you're serious about hunting, you gotta YouTube these guys and just watch a little bit of it, because they're gonna tell you what's up. But one thing that I don't, at least the videos that I've come across, I don't hear them go into detail about pressure. And I want you to have success. I absolutely want you to have success. And I'm telling you, trust me, use wonderground.com, look at the 10-day forecast where you can see the pressure line, and when you have a pressure rise, you want rising pressure. That's the best. And if it's over 30.2, 30.4 is wild. It's just freaking wild. If you get those conditions and can be in the woods, you absolutely have to be in the woods. Thanks, guys.